Hey, Gary, are you talking about your little car accident you had?
What?
I hear gossip. This like you want some office gossip?
Sure. I love office gossip. I never hear it.
Didn't you like drive your friend's car or something? I this is the shit I hear. You know what I'm talking about?
I don't.
You
did you
don't?
Take your friend's car for a test drive and then you drove it over a curb and fucked the tires up?
Oh, yeah. No, I scraped the rim, yeah.
Brand new car.
Brand new Tesla.
Tesla?
Why'd you drive it?
He was insistent that I try it out.
And then how did you drive up on a... I mean, you know how to drive. How did you drive it up on a curb?
I was making a U-turn and the rim scraped against the curb. I thought I cleared it and I didn't.
What do you know about this, Jason?
I know that the friend was so upset he called...
Oh, really?
Oh, he turned Gary in.
So he was like, hey, I bought a brand new fucking Tesla, like right out of the...
Two weeks old.
He
had to
new.
Wait 5 weeks. You know, Teslas are expensive.
Yeah, and they're
and
hard,
they're
to,
hard
get.
To get.
And they're hard
yeah.
to get. So he had to wait 5 weeks to get his. He has his for 2 weeks. He's with Gary. He lets Gary do a test drive. I don't know whose idea it was.
He insisted that I drive it, but okay.
He said immediately Gary wanted to go to a bakery to get black and white cookies.
Jesus.
In his brand new car.
Hold on, that's not true either.
Well, that's what he said.
We went to a bakery because they weren't black and white cookies. They were cookies. We were on our way to a friend's house, and I was bringing them to as a gift. You know, like when you go to someone's house, you bring something to the house.
Right, so you're going to the bakery to get cookies, and Gary, he said, took a sharp U-turn to turn around to go to the bakery, immediately hits the curb. And his friend said, you know, you hear this scraping sound. And I thought Gary was going to stop.
Yeah.
But Gary just leaned into the turn and kept
going.
Yeah, sure,
why not? What does he care?
And he goes, you know, it was the worst noise. He sent us pictures. And at first I was like, oh, it's just the rim. You know, the rim
right,
of a car.
Who cares? Yeah.
Tesla, right? Everything's expensive. One rim, $2,000.
Yeah, you don't know what rims cost.
I felt awful about it. And I've tried everything I can. You don't have to buy a brand new rim. There's people who can repair a rim. And I got a guy who can come and pick it up.
Look,
it was
a brand new car. He needs a new rim.
That's fine. I'll pay for it. It's totally
He disagrees a little with that assessment as well.
Well, what does he say?
They have some weird business deal. This is, again, according to Gary's friend. I didn't talk to Gary about this. But I guess Gary is selling him a pinball machine.
Oh.
I sold him my pinball machine.
And the pinball machine, I guess he sold it for $1,000.
Right.
According to the friend, when this happened, Gary said, hey, listen, man, don't worry about the cost of the pinball machine.
Oh, that's fair.
And the friends gave kind of the obligatory, like, don't worry about it.
Right.
And he goes, in less than 48 hours, Gary cashed the check.
Oh,
so
how come you didn't think about not cashing his check? That way you could have paid for the rims.
I'm not sure that the timing was like that. And I got a guy who gave me an estimate that he could fix the rim for about $200.
But Gary, it was his brand new car.
I understand.
And he wants a brand new rim.
You know what I do, Gary? When people say to me, hey, you want to drive my car?
No.
Yeah, exactly. You just go, you know what, dude? It's a 2 week old car. I'm not that into it. And if you really insist I drive it.
You can give me a ride if you want.
Not my car, not my problem.
That's not true.
Well, I agree with Gary, I think, in this case. I have to say.
But it is so funny that Gary's behind the wheel for 10 seconds.
I know.
Runs it up on a curb. And is it, Gary, is that an accurate description that you hit the curb and then we're just like, fuck it, and just kept going right through it?
Of course it wouldn't say fuck it.
Well, not, you know.
The whole thing happened so fast.
What should he have done?
I hit the curb and I said, let's see how much more damage I can do.
Well, you know, once you start scraping the tire, dude, you know, like, don't drive through the curb.
No, Howard, it just, like, I got, it wasn't like I drove through it. It just kind of happened all at once. You know what I mean?
Yeah. Yeah. I totally.
It wasn't like.
If you hear like, there was some resistance.
I bought him a black and white cookie.
I think that if I had been in that Tesla and that happened to me, that would now be my Tesla, and I'd just go get the guy the new car.
Yeah, that's the right thing to do. I could think about was black and white cookie.
I scraped your rim. Here's a rainbow cookie.
But you know what? The Tesla is a self-driving car.
Right.
You didn't try that.
Not when I drive it.
The guy did make that point. He's like, wow, the auto driver on this car is way better than Gary.
I'll show you how to break it.
They have what they call a valet service.
Right.
Where the car will like come and like Batman, like you can hit the button and they'll
and come
and
get
pick you up.
Yeah.
Oh, I love that.
Oh, that's really,
Hello,
really
car.
Cool.
Uh-oh, hope he doesn't hit the curb. Hello, Mr. Robot.
Sorry about that.
Gary's always involved in something.
I know.